Salutations. I wanted to talk about Mel's Hole. Now, I'm willing to bet that that's something that most of you are very familiar with already, is the story of Mel's Hole. Now, in 1997, I was listening to Coast to Coast AM live with Art Bell, and he had this gentleman on there named Mel Waters. Mel Waters claimed to have this hole on his property outside of Ellensburg, Washington, that was like endless. Somewhere where actually people had been dumping tires or whatever for just years and years and years, and it never ever filled up. So that's part of the story he had, and that he had actually had some fishing line and lowered some things down in there trying to find how deep this hole actually went. So supposedly it was close to what they perceived to be endless. Now, during this interview, providing that this is real or not, that I cannot tell you, but nonetheless some interesting things surround this story. One is the area in Washington near Ellensburg where he said he stayed was at that year, at the time he did this, people looking on there, I looked on there myself, look on Google Maps, it was very new back then, but the region that he said he lived in was blacked out, was like blank. It was very odd. So people started commenting on that then during the time he was talking. I got on there and looked myself. It was kind of interesting, all right? So that's one thing. Something else that was very, very fascinating about this is he said that the hole had always been there. And then he also took some line, like I said, and lowered some things down in there. One of the things that he claimed to lower in there is a lamb, okay? And that this lamb was lowered down, got very nervous when he put it around the hole, when they lowered it down with this contraption or whatever. It was started kind of going crazy, but they lowered it down, and when they bring it back up, for however long he says that they lowered it down there, you can listen to the interview with him and Art Bell and find that out for yourself. When he says they bring it back up, there's this, like, tumor in the middle of it. The lamb is dead, but there's a tumor, like, I guess along his abdomen. And when they cut this thing open, there's some type of a seal, what they described as a seal with human eyes that came out of this tumor, like a sack inside of it. Okay, and this thing, they said that one of the guys wanted to kill it, but he didn't, and they were just kind of mesmerized by this thing, and it wobbles off the table and jumps back into the hole. It goes down into the hole, actually, jumps into the hole. Okay, and it's just something about this seal with human eyes. Now, of course, coincidentally, something else concerning this is that the people around there, the Basque, he talked about them quite a bit, but he said that this seal still came back out of the hole sometimes and communicated with the Basque people with using radio, through the radio frequency, through radios. So I thought that was kind of interesting, all right? Along with the Thunderhawk, the Thunderbirds, and black lights they say could be seen coming in the vicinity of this hole coming out of it, all right? So one other thing that he did was he took, this really I found interesting, is he says he took this ice on this bucket and lowered it down with his fishing line contraption or whatever as a regular bucket of ice. He lowers this down and when they bring it back up, he says it's glowing. And then he describes how one of the men took it to his house, actually used it as an energy source. Now, this sea and how it melted down this the guy's cabin down into the ground and how the military came and confiscated this ice from this cabin and what they had. Now, this stuff was glowing, and to me, when I listened to what his description of it was, it sounded an awful lot like the inner Earth sun, how that was described. And this seal was warning the Basque people through this radio, saying that that ice was very dangerous and could destroy our planet. Now, I find that fascinating, all right? Now, whether or not it's true, I don't know, but when you look at the things of the inner Earth sun, or maybe this takes us into something else, which is what is it actually to transport material from one dimension to another? What all's involved in that? Especially when dealing with the inner Earth, and the inner Earth, you're going so deep, I think you're dealing with certain geometric and pressure type of things that are actually portals to a degree in dimensional frequencies, I think, when you go into the Earth. And I could see something like maybe that movie Predator, where they show them like helping build the pyramids, But at the beginning of that, they show one of the Predator ships in ancient times blowing a hole down to where that pyramid under the ground was with some type of a technology that would be similar to what Phil Nicholson talked about as far as making tunnels. So I can see something like that being done from orbit at the time that was still Cretaceous or before Cretaceous even, when there are so many large animals on this earth that walking the surface was not possible. So just something to think of, all right? So that's just a few things concerning this hole that I want to bring up. A couple of the anomalies. I guess Ellensburg is kind of an interesting place anyway. They have something there called a whale bone tree. It looks very odd. I'll try to put a picture of that on there. I don't know what the history is, what that is, and how that came to be, but there's certainly odd things going on there. So that's just something I want to touch on, this hole. And I think there's other anomalous holes around the earth. Devil's Hole, I think, is another one. So these are just things that could look up. I encourage you to check out Mel's Hole for yourself, what the guy was saying. He was on Art Bell like 3 times, but the first time is the most interesting. So it doesn't mean it's real, but it's worth investigating nonetheless and checking into it. It's good for the psyche, if nothing else. Please subscribe, put a like on this. I'm still trying to beat that algorithm of shadow banning. So I appreciate everybody from Patreon. That's why these videos are still being made. I appreciate the people on YouTube that are giving all the nice comments and starting to talk amongst yourselves. So thank you very much. Peace. Thank you.